These days, there's a lot of focus on maximizing your wealth on the way to retirement. But what about growing and protecting your wealth once you've already retired? Jim Lineweaver is here. He's president and founder of Lineweaver Group. And we were talking about scary stuff before. And retirement can be scary if you have, you know, you have a certain amount of money and it's just starting to dwindle. I guess there's things, strategies you should follow to protect that money and make it grow.
Yeah, there really is, because you don't want a haunted retirement, right?
No.
You know, and usually you don't get a second chance at this. So when it comes to retirement, usually, you know, you're looking at another 20 or 30 years of life. So you have to make sure you put the proper strategies in place for a successful retirement.
Mm-hmm. So when you have strategies, are there a bunch of strategies? Do you have to coordinate these things? And how does it work? And how do you help me do that?
Yeah, well, you hit right on the head. The key is coordination. So you have to coordinate all your financial affairs in retirement, and that's not an easy task.
Okay, so someone has talked me up to a point of retirement, and they say it's going to be great till I'm such and such an age, but things change, don't they?
Well, they really do. So it's really important to make sure you coordinate all your financial, tax, legal, and insurance, and especially in retirement, because you're not going to get a second chance at a lot of these things. And what we find is that people lack this coordination. So they need somebody at a nucleus mm-hmm. or somebody to really coordinate all these different advisors to get them on their team. And we call that a financial quarterback. Mm-hmm. So it's a great analogy, but it really helps people understand that this thing isn't really all that simple and you need a great team for a successful retirement.
So how do your strategies change? Like once you're in retirement?
Well, one of the first things that you have to look at is healthcare. Okay, so some people retire before 65.
And now we're getting letters in the mail like crazy for that. If you're that age, that's what's happening now.
Yeah.
And you really don't know what to do. I would get like 3 or 4 letters a day on this thing.
Yeah, and that may pertain to like Medicare that you're gonna get hit with at 65.
Mm-hmm.
But some people retire before 65, some people retire after. But the key is that in retirement, you know, healthcare, there's a Fidelity study that came out recently that said the average couple in retirement is gonna spend $280,000 on their healthcare in retirement. That's a huge expense. So one way to counter that is we have a lot of people that might take a part-time job, or they have a hobby that they might want to turn into a little business, or we have people that are executives that when they go to retire, they might do some consulting. One of the great things about that is if you can turn this little hobby or something into a business, the tax laws say that you may be able to tax deduct some or all of your health care. So take that $280,000. Could you imagine if you could actually reduce that for 25 to 35% mm-hmm. in retirement? That's a huge windfall to help you in your retirement.
So I say I had $280,000. I know it's going to disappear over the years. It's going to dwindle as I go through my health care. So it might be a good idea to take like $150,000 of that and invest it in something or an idea that could make me money along the way during my retirement?
Oh, you have to shift your assets. So you have to make sure that what you're going to do is you're not in a growth mode anymore. You have to shift it to income. So you want things that can provide a good dividend for your income so that no matter what's going on with the volatility in the market like we've seen the last few
right.
weeks, you're still getting a dividend, you're still getting paid, so you can still do those bucket list items in your retirement that you want to do.
So you can figure out ways and things that people can do based on what their past experiences are and what got them to this place in life?
Exactly, but everybody's situation is a little unique, right?
Right.
So you have to customize this. It's not a cookie cutter approach, and that's why this team's so important, because everybody, you know, that you put in maybe a room or an auditorium,
yeah.
they all could be the same age in retirement, but have all different situations and scenarios.
And one of the things I've discovered is you sort of get tunnel vision. You don't recognize and realize all the potential you have other than what you've been doing all these years. And somebody from the outside can see you differently than you see yourself and help you in that respect.
They really can. And that's why this team approach comes in, because, you know, not only we talked about income, but you got to minimize the taxes along the way.
Mm-hmm.
Matter of fact, not too long ago, we had an individual that they came to us, and here the prior years, they created a dream wedding for their daughter. It was fabulous. And now they're wondering why they're paying a lot more in taxes, and also why did their Medicare premium go up this following year?
Right.
Well, when we sat down with their accountant and looked at all the other investments and everything that they had, we found that they could have still paid for that dream wedding, but in a much more tax efficient way. Matter of fact, we could have saved them over $7,000 in taxes
mm-hmm.
and not had to pay this additional Medicare premium. So I'm all for paying my fair share of taxes,
right.
but I don't want to pay a dime more than I have to. That's why this coordination is so important.
So you're sort of coordinating a window, almost like a crystal ball for these folks. You know what's down the road, and a lot of these people don't, and you can alert them to these things to benefit them.
Yeah, not only that, you're going to be creating or facing a lot of forks in the road.
And oh, yeah.
If you didn't do the planning in the past, you may be forced down one path that you don't want to go on. So you have to be proactive.
Why didn't I do that? Like
you
that,
have
right?
to be proactive in retirement. Right. You cannot just wait to what comes your way. You mm-hmm. have to be proactive to get the retirement that you want.
Okay, so we're just scratching the surface here. So you'll come back and give us some more specific ways to protect our retirement and continue to live the good life.
I'd love to. That'd be great.
Thank you very much. Okay, folks, if you're wondering about employing and coordinating the right financial strategies, you might want to give Jim a call at Lineweaver Financial Group and catch the Financial Quarterback. That's right here on Fox Sunday mornings. That's just before the Chris Wallace Show, so you can check that out and learn a whole lot more. And of course, Jim will be back. And of course, we have more New Day Cleveland coming up right after the break.